drinks quid. It's my first time up here, so by the way. Yeah, thanks for the fucking support. What about you guys over there? You came all the way from Cranbourne. You're gonna give me a fucking hell now. Fucking friends. Anyway.
You can do this.
I can do this. You know why? Because I quit. I quit my job today.
Yeah.
Woo! Don't quit your day job. I already did. Fuck, I'm fucking, this isn't working. Alright. So, yeah, let me get one of those. So, yeah, my name's, well, you'll find out later. So, I quit my job today, right? I didn't quit last week, right? I did it, I quit it, wrote the fucking emails, I did all the reports, I spoke to all my parents who are fucking home with all my kids, 125 fucking kids, I'm a teacher at a high school. I quit, I'm fucking done. Yeah, that's what you asked me before, what do you do? I'm a teacher, I'm an English teacher. Do we have any English teachers in the fucking room?
No.
Do you have any students in the room? Right, so these jokes are fucking lame. So I quit. It came to my attention that schools are run by fucking psychopaths that try and fucking groom these 13-year-old boys to fucking act in a way that society potentially is trying to get them to behave. Like some kind of moral fucking contest measured by a shit like fucking The Bachelor. And what a little fucking reality TV show people fucking watch. Anyway, if I quit. Now I'll tell you why, it's the little things. It's the little things that made me fucking, you know, just like flip my mind. So like, one day, I remember the day, well, this is like 2 weeks ago, right? I was like fucking having one of those like free periods. So if you're not teachers, if you're not students, you don't realize that teachers can whack class as well. Did you know that? Yeah. When we have a free period, we fucking sit in an office and just fucking email. So I decided on this fucking Friday, it was a nice sunny day. I was like, fuck this, I'm gonna go for a walk and just look around. So anyway, are you still with me? Alright. Yeah. Give me a fucking hell yeah if you're still with me, right? Alright. So I was walking around, I was like, yeah, you know, teaching's not bad, but I'm kind of like, I'm a bit sus with some of these teachers, but I reckon that they're psychopaths. Now, I'm not saying that word lightly. Like, when you think psychopath, you think fucking, like, oh, yeah? A psychopath is someone who doesn't engage with empathy. Yeah? So I was in a hallway, and so I saw this fucking teacher talking to this kid called Jack Wag. That's not a pun. This kid fucking wags class all the fucking time. I always pull him up and I'm like, dude, you better get in your fucking classes. I'm like, no, let's go, let's go. So I ship him into these classes, right? The thing is, these classes are run by wolves. Wolves and sheep clothing, yeah? Do anyone have kids? Yeah? How old are they?
17.
So they should know all about this shit. Cal, you got kids. How about all your kids? Alright, so we're gonna air out all the dirty laundry. Anyways, so I was walking down the hall, and this kid Jack was just standing in the hall, and this fucking teacher, I will not name names, but he's basically giving me a whole fucking schooling of how to give like a genuine apology. And it went like this. Now, Jack. You do know that society these days, they do appreciate you actually saying an apology so you actually believe in it. So if you don't give an apology that you don't believe in, you shouldn't do it. I was like, fuck, this is pretty heavy for a fucking Saturday morning. Not Saturday school. So I was like, I walked up, I was like, hey, this is shit. This wasn't the room, this is the closet. Jack, what'd you do? And Jack didn't answer. The kid, the teacher actually answered for him. Like, well, Jack wasn't chewing too loud in class. He was like, right, Jack, how loud were you chewing? He's like, too seriously. you wouldn't be having this conversation if you were chewing that softly, like how loud were you actually chewing? And Cal was like, well, actually, Cal was the teacher. Well, actually, he was chewing pretty loud. He was like, you know, chewing in front of this guy's ear, and like, he didn't like me. I was like, who's the kid that was annoying? He points to this kid in the fucking class, and the kid's got these fucking noise production headphones on his fucking head, sitting in the corner, looking miserable. I was like, that kid? You were chewing too loud for that kid? That's your son. What's his name?
AJ.
AJ. Close.
I locked the door.
I know where I recognize you from. Parent-teacher interviews, right?
Oh.
Bye.
That's where it came from.
True. Right. We're going to talk.
We don't. Apparently, he didn't like him as a teacher.
I want to see what happens to you. Anyway, so, yeah. You would. Anyway, so I pulled him out of class. My excuse is like, and I said, Jack, and the other kid's called G, right? He's this big Harry kid, he's fucking new, you know, his headphones on. So what's the fucking situation here? Jack, what's the big deal? And Jack's like, I was like, Jack, what's the big deal? Why are you guys fucking rivaling? And he's like, well, you know, life sucks. I was like, really? What are you? Headphone boy, what are you fucking doing for? And they all kind of agree with it. So wait a minute. So the two of you agree that life sucks.
Yeah,
kind of. Alright. So, while I was thinking, why don't you just fucking like sit behind a desk, film yourselves talking about why life sucks every fortnight, right? And then come up. Whoops, sorry. Why don't you try and fucking like, you know, do it properly and get it from like 10,000 subscribers on YouTube, put that shit up on YouTube, monetize it, eventually get some money, fucking roll in it, get 21 millionaires, fucking living in the lyrics, like to go to boats, to go on fucking like traveling, take a lot of drugs. No, I'm not saying that teenagers should take drugs, especially now. I'm not saying that. No.
Yeah,
I'm just saying that there comes a point in time in a man's life, or a woman's life, if you're an
equal,
where you're going to come across weed and you're going to choose whether you're going to enjoy it or it's going to be bad for you, and if it's good for you, as long as it's good for you, then you go on being a good person and treat people with respect and actually understand their situation before actually making judgment calls. As long as you treat people with respect and you're empathizing and not being a psychopathic teacher, being aggressive and passive at the same time, and emotionally manipulative, then everything will be okay. Something like heaven, my God. That's a little mixture. Now I want you to reach under your tables and grab each of those fucking little nubs of weed that I've taped under your chairs and smoke them out right now.
Yeah!
I'm not fucking kidding! Grab them in your face! I went in here before at 4 p.m. I laid them underneath the table. Right? Alright. So the story that I know you're going to wrap up and stuff, but I just got one last point to make. Alright? 20 seconds, right? 20, 9, 10, 10, 10, 10, 15, 15, 15. At the end of the day, you know, drugs are what you do with them. If you run to them, fine. But you can still live a fucking good life on them. And where's my fucking commercial? Alright? I'm a teacher, I smoke weed, I teach really good, I love my fucking job. I've got good friends who are here to fucking back me up. Kelly, Clint, Ryan, Ross fucking girlfriend, Ryan Brother, dude with the camera who's from Germany and just picks up a dozen shit on the fucking fly. She's full of shit. And it takes a lot of guts to get up here and do this shit, right?
Woo!
really boring.
Yeah.